Can you explain the issue of getting car insurance? Car insurance is a contract, and that is actions. And every action in Islam required to have to be based on hukum shar'i. If we already claim to be subservient to Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we must remember all the time, every action you do, every action you carry, you must carry it based on the divine text, salati wa nusuki wa mahyaya wa mamati lillahi rabbil alameen la sharika la. So every action you do, your life, your ritual act, your prayer, your life affairs, and your death, all for the sake of Allah. So now the Messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in the hadith reported by Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha, that kullu amalin laysa alayhi amruna fahuwa rad, any action not based on our teaching is not valid. And this is why those actions which is people they may involve in, they will be accountable for that. فَوَرَبِّكَ لَنَسْأَلَنَّهُمْ أَجْمَعِينَ عَمَّا كَانُوا يَعْمَلُونَ. By your Lord, we're going to question all what they do. So whatever you do, if it's based on the command of Allah and His messengers, you will be rewarded for. If it's not based on the command of Allah and His messengers, you're going to be accountable for. So it's going to be rejected if your action not based on the Sharia. Insurance is a contract, like any other contract. And that action required from you to know the act. Not enough to go and sign contract. You need to study it first. Insurance is a form of bay' al-gharar. It's a form of prohibited form of trades. Because contract in Islam must be either for good or service. Must be only, the contract in Islam must be on a particular goods to buy or service. So either you buy car or you benefit from a service, somebody to do service for your car, MOT for example. And could be in return certain values, certain price, or could be free of charge. That's why there's four forms of contract in Islam. عَقْدٌ عَلَىٰ عَيْنٍ بِعِوَضٍ عَقْدٌ عَلَىٰ عَيْنٍ بِغَيْرِ عِوَضٍ عَقْدٌ عَلَىٰ مَنْفَعَ بِعِوَضٍ عَقْدٌ عَلَىٰ مَنْفَعَةٍ بِغَيْرِ عِوَضٍ. It's going to be contract for a particular items in return a particular price, like to buy car for £5,000 for example, contract for a goods in return certain price. And there is contracts on a goods but without anything in returns, like what? You could be a survey, borrow the car, I lend you my car. Or could be you could hire the car for paying certain rent. Here, benefit. You are just getting benefit. You're not really getting the car. Or you could be عَقْدٌ عَلَىٰ عَيْنٍ بِغَيْرِ عِوَضٍ. Could be a contract for a particular goods in return. There's nothing in return. That's, you know, if I lend you my car, استعارة. Insurance does not fit in any of those forms of Islamic contracts. Is neither goods to buy and is not service, and therefore is bay'ul gharar. Not to mention, you try to guarantee and secure the futures, what's going to happen. Whether car insurance or life insurance or whatever is forbidden. Wallahu a'lam. Therefore, don't let anybody fool you, say third party. Third party is what? In the end, is a contract. Whether the contract is comprehensive or third party. So, don't tell me now, are you going to live? Because the law said you must have insurance, so you're going to insure your car. So forget now to obey Allah. Obey the law of the land. That's it. You are subservient to Almighty Allah. If you cannot really obey Allah in this matter, at least do not justify it to do like you. Just say, Ya Akhi, I'm weak, corrupted, whatever you want to call yourself. But don't sell out to the people that insurance is allowed.
Sheikh, is it halal to work as a taxi driver if it involves taking insurance out on the car? To work taxi driver is allowed, but not to be involved in doing something haram. That's all. To be taxi driver is allowed, but doesn't mean to do something haram. sometimes could be the work is allowed, the job is allowed, but is something beside. You see, something is not part of the job, something else, it could be not allowed. So don't be involved if that is not allowed. Allah.
Question, this guy told me that it's okay to buy car insurance because it is out of necessity, because it will cost too much to take bus, taxi. How can I answer?
Okay. He has a very distorted understanding of necessity. Okay. It costs too much to get the bus. I know for a fact it costs you more to run a car with all this insurance than it costs you to get on the bus. I know because I get the bus. Okay. It's not a necessity at all for people to say, I have to get car insurance. It's ridiculous. It's absolutely ridiculous. And even if it was a necessity, who told you that necessity by itself, just any necessity, makes all the things haram into halal? This is a rejected principle in usul, does not exist. Okay, what they say is, الضرورات تبيح المحظورات. They said that the necessity makes halal permissible all the prohibited things. This principle does not exist among the Salaf at all. This was invented in the last 100 years. It never existed among the Salaf. It is a rejected principle which they are trying to fuse together correct principles about duress and about compulsion, ittirar. Okay, and it does not fit into what we're talking about today. We don't say riba becomes halal because of necessity, bribery becomes halal, and the shirk becomes halal, and the zina becomes halal because of necessity. It's not acceptable. You know? It's not acceptable. The haram, Allah Ta'ala revealed the sharia in order for us to, you know, abide by it and to live our lives according to the sharia. You know, if there is a necessity, we look to the sharia method of fulfilling that necessity, not to just permit what Allah forbade. So those who say that car insurance is halal because of the necessity of high bus prices and travel prices, you know, they are distorting the reality and the ahkam. Okay. First of all, insurance is a form of riba and a form of gambling and is a prohibited transaction. Nothing can be a permit for that except by a divine evidence, by clear evidence from the Quran and the Sunnah. And there's no evidence at all to permit these type of riba transactions out of necessity.